In this video, we're going to be talking about Newton's method. So let's preface this with a quick example. So we want to solve the equation ln of x plus 4x equals 0. Now, at first glance, this might look quite easy, but the more and more you go through it, you'll find that it's pretty much impossible to isolate x by itself and really get a solution. So we can't really solve this by hand, at least not given the tools that we currently have. However, we might be able to approximate it and get a pretty good approximation at that. And so that's really what Newton's method is all about. It's about approximating the solutions to these kinds of equations, specifically looking for the zeros of any given equation, right? So that's what we're going to be looking at today. So this is the formula associated with Newton's method. Might look a little convoluting, but we'll talk about it. But we have x sub n plus 1 equals x sub n minus f of x sub n over f prime of x sub n. So a few notes I would like to go over with you about this process. So Newton's method is what we call an iterative process. Iterative process. And what does this mean? It means that you will do this several times, right? It's something that you repeat a couple of times. So here's how you really go about doing it. So you pick an initial value for x sub n. This is usually given to you, or you might have to look at a graph. There's a lot of intuition behind that we'll talk about later on, but you pick an initial value for x sub n, then you use this formula, plug in for x sub n into this side of the equation, you'll get a number, right? And you will get a number for x sub n plus 1, and then you take what you get for x sub n plus 1 and plug it back into the formula and repeat this process again, right? And that's really the iterative element to this, to this whole thing, right? You start with something, you plug in an initial value, solve for it, and then what you get becomes the next input for your function, right? You keep doing this until you get a zero for your function, right? Typically, this takes 3 to 4 iterations, depending on where you start with this starting point in this step here, right? So let's look at an example, just so you can kind of see what we're really doing here. All right, so here's the same equation that we saw at the start of the video. So let's see if we can use Newton's method to approximate the solutions to that. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to choose x sub 0 to equal 1. The reason for that is because it's approximately close to where we think the 0 might be, and also just because it's a very nice number to start with. So let's start with that. And also, so we're just going to start with that. But before we even actually start plugging and chugging into the formula, the first thing we need to do is we need to find our derivative. We need to find our derivative. Because we need this guy to work this formula, right? So if we do this, we get f prime of x is simply going to be, remember, the derivative of natural log is just 1 over x. So we will have 1 over x plus derivative of 4x is just going to be 4. And that's our derivative. And that's all we're going to do with that for now. Now we can start doing our iterations, right? So let's look at iteration 1. Iteration 1 of Newton's method, right? So the first, what we're going to do is we're going to say, all right, x sub 1 is going to be equal to x sub 0, which in this case we just know to be 1. So it's going to be x sub 0, which is 1, minus, we're going to have f of 1 over f prime of 1. This comes out to 1 minus f of 1, ln f of 1, if we plug this in, ln of 1 is just 0, plus 4 times 1 is just going to be 4, right? Over, if we plug in 1 into this guy, we get 1 plus 4, which is going to be 5, which, and this guy is just going to come out to 1/5. It's my, for, as my x sub 1, right? So that's my first iteration. Next thing we can do, we will run our second iteration, right? So, and we're going to use x sub 1 in our second iteration. So we'll say, all right, so x2 is going to be equal to x1 now is going to be the guy we plug in. So we'll be 1/5, right, minus f of 1/5 over f prime. 1/5. Okay. Running a little short of space here, but we'll have 1/5 minus, if we plug in 1/5 into this guy, we will have ln of 1/5 plus 4/5. If we plug in 1/5 into the derivative, we're simply going to get 5 plus 4, which will be 9, right? Because 1 over 1/5 is just 5, 5 plus 4 is 9. And unfortunately, that is a bit of an ugly number, so we can't actually evaluate that without using a calculator. So if we plug in this guy into a calculator, what we end up getting is approximately 0.289, right, to 3 decimal places. And that's our x2, right? So we've got this guy here. And now we plug him in to find through our next iteration. Oh, so we should call this iteration 2. Now we're going to do iteration 3, right, which is going to be defined x3. And this is the last one we'll do, just keeping time in mind. So x3, now we're going to plug in x2, which is 0.289, minus f of 0.289 over f prime. 0.289. Cool. And if we were to flesh this out a little bit more, we get 0.289 minus, we'd have the ln 0.289 minus 4 times 0.289 over 1 over 0.289. plus 4. Once again, that's a pretty ugly number, so we will need a calculator. One piece of advice that I do have, though, is that when you're plugging this x2 in for all these places, be sure to not just round this up right away, but actually, take the actual, just actually store this output as a separate variable and use that in everything, because you don't want to lose accuracy by rounding your number too soon, right? But this eventually is going to come out to, it's about 0.3005. Okay? And that right there is where we're going to stop. We could go further if we wanted to. We could do many, many more iterations, and we'd probably get a very, very accurate answer after that. But that's where we're going to stop for now. So now to get an idea of how accurate that 0 is, what we'll need to do is we can say, all right, so what's f of 0.3005, right? And if you plug that into your calculator, what you'll actually get is that's approximately 0.00064. That's negative, but negative 0.0064. And that's a very small number, right? This is very small. And pretty close to 0. So this is like on the order of 1 over 10,000. So this is on the order of 1 over 10,000. So that's a really, really small number. So we can say that this is pretty darn close to 0. So this is a pretty decent estimation, right? So this guy that we have right here is a pretty good estimation. We can make it better for sure if we wanted to, but that's already a really good estimation. So I hope you understood from this how Newton's method really works, right? So we start with this initial value, right? And then we just keep iteratively plugging this stuff in, right? And that's all I'm going to have for this video. If you found this video helpful, please do like, share, subscribe, leave a comment, and check out some other videos. See you next time!